Hello, and welcome to TI Precision Labs. In this session, we'll be discussing signal conditioner considerations in CPRI applications. CPRI stands for Common Public Radio Interface. The CPRI protocol defines a serial interface between radio equipment and radio control equipment. CPRI links commonly carry high-speed data between remote radio units, called RRUs, and baseband units, called BBUs. This block diagram shows an example of a BBU system, a RRU system, and the CPRI link between these systems, which is responsible for facilitating high-speed communication between these systems. This block diagram also shows locations where signal conditioning may be necessary, as indicated by the SIGCON block. Signal conditioning may be required for front port or backplane communication. When designing signal conditioning into CPRI systems, there are several considerations that should be made when selecting a signal conditioner. One consideration to make is regarding the target CPRI rates for a CPRI system. Here we see CPRI line rates. CPRI has several different line rates spanning a wide range from 0.6144 gigabits per second to 24.3302 gigabits per second. These rates also have different line codings of either 8B10B or 64B66B. If a retimer is being considered as a signal conditioner in a CPRI application, it's important to consider the retimer CDR lock rate since retimers have a limited lock range. Retimers typically support lock-in to a range of data rates and subrates of these data rates. Looking at the examples in this slide, we can see two different retimers and their supported data rates. Retimer 1 has a higher full rate data range than retimer 2, but does not support lock-in to 8th rate subrates. As a result, retimer 1 can lock to a higher CPRI data rate than retimer 2. But cannot lock to several lower CPRI data rates that are supported by retimer 2. When designing a signal conditioner into a CPRI application, it's also important to consider the signal conditioner equalization capability. One of the key receiver equalization methods that redrivers and retimers use is continuous time linear equalization, or CTLE. CTLE applies high-frequency boost to signals in order to compensate for insertion loss. CTLE does not apply equal boost across all frequencies, so it's important to consider the required equalization for a given data rate when selecting a signal conditioning device. This graph shows an example CTLE boost curve. We can see that CPRI rate 10 will receive more boost than CPRI rate 5. Because of this, it's important to consider the target data rate and the associated insertion loss with that data rate when selecting a signal conditioner. Another important consideration when selecting a signal conditioner for a CPRI application is the target electrical specifications. The CPRI specification defines several different physical layer specifications for various optical and electrical connections. The Electrical Physical Layer Specification section of the CPRI standard has details on which specifications are supported. One chip-to-module electrical interface commonly used for CPRI is the SFI specification. As an example, we are showing the SFI host transmitter electrical eye mask. When selecting a signal conditioner to use in an SFI application, it's important to ensure the signal conditioner can meet the SFI electrical specification. A signal conditioner with a minimum transmit amplitude of 900 millivolts peak-to-peak differential would not be suitable for SFI, since the SFI eye mask establishes a maximum amplitude of 700 millivolts peak-to-peak differential. Thanks for watching our session on signal conditioner considerations for CPRI applications. To review what we've discussed, let's take a short quiz. 1. Which line coding is not used by CPRI? A. 8B10B, B, 64B, 66B, C, 128B, 130B. The answer is C, 128B, 130B. 2. Why is it important to look at CTLE boost at specific frequencies? A. CTLE boost applied to a signal is dependent on signal data rate. B. CTLE boost will improve reflections at certain frequencies. C. CTLE boost frequencies dictate which rates a retimer can lock to. The answer is A. CTLE boost applied to a signal is dependent on signal data rate. 3. What is the impact of retimer CDR lock range in CPRI applications? A. Retimers are always a superior choice to redrivers since they can lock to all line rates. B. Some retimers with limited lock ranges may not be suitable for a CPRI application. C. Retimer lock range determines the propagation delay of the retimer. The answer is B. Some retimers with limited lock ranges may not be suitable for a CPRI application.